astronaut ice cream. Actually eaten by people who actually pretend to be astronauts. We have a Space Invaders ice cube tray because you know, your party is out of this world. And then we have this fantastic interactive Tribble. I know, right? So you know if there's a Klingon in the room? Yeah. And a $15 gift certificate to thinkgeek.com. What's not to love, right? Okay, so let me shake this up really good. Okay. Would you be so kind as to pull up a slip out of here and like hand it to me and I'll go back to the spotlight to announce the winner? Bless you. Peter Bakley.
That gave us all a reason to dream. There was a place where we could all belong. In the darkness of the cinema, we could prosper and the bond. It was the science fiction movie.
We found ourselves in peril, but made it back unscathed.
give our flag a peace we wave, disseminating wisdom, and on my arm some green chick, and I was always whipping out my laser. Gather all the wormholes, the tribbles, the attacks, the androids, the salt sucker, a snappy compact. Ah, damn it, now it's time to face the facts. This is our final act. I'd like a quiet planet somewhere in the Cygnet branch, and settle down with someone on a Roddenberry ranch. She'll be so fine with love, I'll be happy with my luck. Yes, that's the life we should have retired long ago.
In facing our mortality, we face our greatest foe.
That is the hardest to admit. We're too old for this.
My laser? I just had it a minute ago, and I always hang it on this side. I never hang it on this side. Shit.
Remember when we were all the rage? Now we're living in another age.
Go.
What was that? We were under attack. Attack by whom? Unknown, Captain.
Sound good?
Jim, I'm a doctor, not a crash test dummy. When are we going to get some seatbelts for this tin can? Warp speed, Spock.
We have insufficient power, Captain.
You wanted some excitement, not funny bones. Scotty, damage report.
It doesn't look good, Captain. The fuel injection split in the carburetor and the altimeter's fixing the intake regulator.
How long before we get power?
We're stranded until AAA brings us some temper cable. Unless you'd like to go out into deep space and push.
You've got 10 minutes to get it working.
Aye,
Captain. Damn it, Jim, you've got to do something. We're sitting ducks out here.
The enemy wishes to discuss our surrender, Captain.
Surrender? Open communications channels.
Captain James T. Kirk, I have found you at last.
Have we met before?
Of course. You don't know who I am. That puts you at a serious disadvantage. You wouldn't remember SETI Alpha 5.
SETI Alpha 5? What are you talking about?
Damn it, Jim. Did you sleep with this guy? I know what goes on SETI Alpha 5.
He doesn't possess a spectacular physique.
I didn't sleep with him. I don't even know who he is.
That never stopped you before.
Let me introduce myself before I extinguish your feeble lives. You can call me
Khaaaaan. Why are you attacking my ship?
I want revenge. Revenge is a dish best served cold. With butterscotch syrup and a cherry on top. Now I have you at my mercy and I can gloat over your incontinence.
Excuse me, but I think you mean incompetence.
No, I mean you're going to wet your pants.
That depends. On what you plan to do with us.
Isn't it obvious what I plan to do? I plan to kill you.
No! No, please, no! We begged you! Bones, what are you doing?
I pledge.
Why kill us? What have we done?
It's not what you've done, it's what you're going to do. The Genesis device can't save you now.
The Genesis device? I don't know what you're talking about.
I'm talking about my plans for world domination that you destroyed oh so long ago. Now it is time for me to rise again.
Captain, if I may, our foe appears to be a very two-dimensional character. And may you best appeal to his predictability.
Come, you wait. We're at your mercy.
Excellent. At last I can have my sweet revenge.
Sweet?
Yeah, you remember the thing about the butterscotch.
Khan, it's me you want. Spare the lives of my crew.
You are in no position to negotiate.
You have me at a disadvantage. You know all about me, and I don't know anything about you.
Well, allow me to tell you all about me, Captain Kirk.
Goals.
He has held a grudge ever since.
Nearly three centuries.
The logical thing to do would be to go back in time and prevent Khan before he becomes successful.
Are you mad? We've already transported our atoms all over space. Time travel is far too dangerous.
The odds of serious incident during time travel are approximately 3,720 to 1. Considering our situation, it is a risk worth taking.
Oh yeah? Well, what about the conundrums? Anything we do in the past could change the future. We might just time travel ourselves right out of existence.
I fail to see how that is relevant, Doctor, since it is apparent from Khan's vow of vengeance that we are destined to go back in time in order to maintain our present. The only danger we face is not going back, since that would undoubtedly alter our current situation.
Damn it, Jimmy. He's lost. Hawk is right, Bones. We've got to go back in time. You always take his side. Issue a red alert and engage temporal displacement.
Yes, Captain. Time and space, we will displace capacitor with plutonium base. We are masters of time and space.
Approximate temporal location is the year 2010. you would like to want to hang me?
Unfortunately, no. It requires something with a little more kick. Plutonium!
Game over, man. Game over.
I've seen things you people wouldn't believe.
Turn this crap off. I didn't see any of this in the history books.
Leslie, Jeff, our sensors indicate that the fashions and culture of artifacts are strictly from the decade of the 1980s, nearly 30 years prior to our current age.
Could the time travel projections be off by 3 decades?
Negative, Captain. All temporal readings are accurate.
Gather a security team and beam down the house. That's an order.
Captain, there appears to be a situation that you need to be aware of.
What is it?
We seem to be experiencing a shortage of security personnel.
What? Damn it, Jim. Every time we beam a security officer to the surface of a new planet, they're immediately killed. Jim, you never notice? Thank you. How do we get started?
Good time.
Justin, you've got another thing coming. This is the final countdown. And with a rebel yell, I will rock you like a hurricane.
Adam?
together, it should meld the tune to their psyches, and we can override their primitive communication systems with the Genesis device.
The court neutralizes the line.
You think I'll change that? Ahura, pitch, please.
Create new art and
no longer be subjected to power ballads and synth bands. You will be a lesson to future generations about the dangers of entrusting the world's culture to a greedy, power-mongering profiteer like yourself.
What's going to happen to me?
Leave it to me, Captain. I'll make him the emblem of bad taste so the world never again has to suffer through something like crawl.
It could have been worse. It could have been disco. No!
Our place. Yes. Well, this is so stadium-like.
I like this.
And, you know, we have so much of the space is wasted because of those damn pillars there.
Yeah.
But, so we don't get any of that angle.
Oh, okay.
But, you know, whatever it is, it's pretty good.
They do it. I don't know for sure. I don't touch any buttons, and for that I'm eternally grateful.